Twas on one April morning, just as the sun was rising. Twas on one April morning, I heard the small birds sing. They were singing, lovely Nancy, for love it is a fancy, and a sweet were the notes that I heard the small birds sing. Young men are false and full of all deceiving. Young men are false and they seldom do prove true. For they're roving and they're ranging, and their minds are always changing, and they're thinking for to find out some other girl that's new. Oh, if I had but my own heart in keeping, oh, if I had but my own heart back again, close in my bosom, I would lock it up forever, and it should wander never so far from me again. So why would you spend all your long time in courting? Why would you spend all your long time in vain? For I don't intend to marry, I would rather longer tarry. Oh, young man, don't you spend all your single life in vain. 'Twas on one April morning, just as the sun's rising. 'Twas on one April morning, I heard the small birds sing. They were singing, lovely Nancy, for love it is a fancy, and a sweet were the notes that I heard the small bird sing.
As I rode out one May morning, all at the dawning of the day, I heard two brothers a-making moan, and listened a while to what they did say. We have a brother in prison, said they, all in the prison lieth he. If we had 10 men like ourselves, we soon should set the prisoner free. Oh no, oh no, both the key cried, and oh, oh no, it never can be. If 40 men would be little enough, and I've to ride in their company. 10 for to hold the horses in, 10 to guard the city about, and 10 to stand at the prison door, and 10 for the letting bold archer out. So they mounted their horses and so rode they, but they so merrily rode till they came to the riverside, and there they alighted so manfully. They mounted their horses and so swam they, but they so manfully swam till they came to the other side, and there they alighted so drippingly. They mounted their horses and so rode they, but they so gallantly round till they came to the prison door, and there they alighted so daringly. Oh, watcher, bold the Gee cried, look you not so mournfully, I've 40 men in my company, and we here come to set you free. Oh, noble archer, he cried, and no, it never can be, a 40 weight of good Spanish iron between me ankle and my knee. But Dickie broke locks and Dickie broke keys, and Dickie broke everything he could see. He took the bold archer under his arm and carried him out so manfully. And they mounted their horses and so rode they, but they so gallantly rode till they came to the riverside, and there they alighted so daringly. Oh, Dickie, bold archer, he cried, take me love to me wife and me children three. My horse, it is lame, he cannot swim, and here I fear that I must die. But they changed their horses and so swam they, but they so gallantly swam till they came to the other side, and there they alighted so shiveringly. Oh, Dickie, bold archer, he cried, look you yonder there and see, I think I see the old sheriff a-coming, 100 men in his company. Dickie, the sheriff, he cried, you are the worst rascal ever I see, and give me back the iron you stole, and I will set the prisoner free. I am like an owl that flies by night, and I fly from tree to tree, the iron will do to shoe our horses, the blacksmith rides in our company. Oh, Dickie, the sheriff, he cried, you are the worst rascal ever I see, to thank you for nothing, bold Dickie, he cried, and you were a fool for following me.
Come all you young fellows, wherever that you be, I pray pay attention and listen unto me. For by a young female I'm wounded full soon, and you see I'm cut down in the height of me bloom. It was last Monday evening I lay in me bed, when a young man come to me and this to me said, rise up, Henry Higgins, and flee you elsewhere, for they're bound out against you on the word of Fanny Blair. Fanny Blair is a girl of 11 years old, and if I was a-dying, then the truth I'd unfold. For I never had dealings with her in me time, but now I've to pay for some other man's crime. On the day of the trial, Squire of Vernon was there, and on that green table they did lift young Fanny Blair, and the lies that she swore to, I'm ashamed for to tell. But the judge spoke up quickly, saying, you've told us it well. Henry Higgins of Branfield, oh, whither art thou flown? For it's you're a poor prisoner, condemned and alone. If Jackie MacNeil of Newcastle was here, in spite of old Vernon, we'd soon have you clear. On the day that young Higgins was condemned to die, all the people rose up with a murmuring cry, we'll catch her, we'll crop her, she's a perjuring little whore. Young Henry isn't innocent, of that we're very sure. So just one thing remains before my life to end. Don't bury me in that prison yard, so far from any friend. Bring my body to lie in the sweet Branfield mould. And I pray the Lord pardon that little girl's soul. One midsummer's evening, sunbeam gone down. A young Polly went walking by the side of a pond. She sat under the shady trees, showers for to shine. A weather apron wrapped around her, white as swan. Young Willie went hunting with his dog and his gun. Young Willie went hunting as the evening came on. Down among those green rushes as the evening came on, he shot his own true love in the room of a swan. When he'd seen what he'd done, away he run, crying, "Father, dear father, do you see what I've done?" Down among those green rushes as the evening came on, I shot my own true love in the room of a swan. Stay at home, dear Willie, till your trial do come on, that you may not be banished to some far land. On the day of your trial, your father will appear with 100 bright guineas, if that will you clear. On the day of the trial, young Polly did appear, crying, "People, oh people, let Willie go clear." Down among those green rushes as the evening came on, he shot his own true love in the room of a swan.
Now a famous farmer, as you shall hear, he had two sons and one daughter dear. Her servant man, she much admired, none in the world that she loved so dear. Said one brother to the other, see how our sister means to wed. Let all such a courtship soon be ended, we'll hoist him to some silent grave. They called for him to go a-hunting. He went without any fear or strife. And these two jewels, they proved so cruel, they took away that young man's life. It was near the creek, where there was no water. Nothing but bushes and the briars grew, all for to hide their cruel slaughter. Into the bushes his body threw. When they returned from the field of hunting, she began to inquire for a servant man. Come, brothers, tell me, because you whisper. Come, brothers, tell me if you can. Sister, we are so much amazed to see you look so much at we. We've left him where we've been hunting, no more of him than did we see. And she lay musing all on her pillow. She dreamed she saw her true love stand by her bedside. Stood lamenting, all covered with some bloody wounds. Nancy, dear, don't you weep for me. Pray, Nancy, dear, don't weep nor pine. In that creek where there is no water, go there you shall, my boy. Body fine. So she rose early the very next morning, with many a sigh and bitter groan. In that place where a true lover told her, it's there she's found his body thrown. The blood all on his lips was drying, his tears were salter than any brine. And then she's kissed him, loudly crying, here lies a bosom, a friend of mine. Nights and days she stayed lamenting, until her poor heart was filled with woe. Until sharp hunger came creeping on her, and homeward she was forced to go. Sister, we are so much amazed to see you look so pale and wan. Brothers, I know you know the reason, and for the same you shall be hung. These two brothers both were taken and bound all down in some prison strong. They both were tried, found out as the guilty, and for the same they both were hung.
Now, when I was a young man, I was a rover, and nothing wouldn't satisfy me but a wife. A long, long ere I was the age of 20, a weary I was of the single life. Kissing and a clapping was my occupation, among the females I did roam. Now I am married and I live at me leisure, but the poor man's labours are never o'er. When first I married my wife Janet, out of her company I could not stay. Her voice it was sweeter than the lark or the linnet or the nightingale at the break of day. But now she's fairly altered her meaning, and now she's a fairly altered her tune. Nothing but scoldings comes up her throat, so the poor man's labours are never done. In the first half year that we was married, I scarce didn't get 1.5 hour sleep.
With her to a heel she rubbed my shin, said, husband dear, putting down your feet. And it's when I asked her what was the meaning, her answer to me was a come, come, come. Young men's wives, they must have pleasure, so the poor man's labours are never done. In the next half year that we was a married, she brought to me, oh, a loving babe, setting me down to rock that cradle and give it and cowdy when it waked. When it cried as she bitterly scolded, to the door I was forced to run. Without trousers, a wig or waistcoat, the poor man's labours are never done. So it's I went up to the top of the hill to view my sheep, they had all gone astray. When I come back, she was lying in her bed at 12 o'clock on a winter's day. When I come back, both wet and weary, wetted and weary, where could I run? She was lying in her bed, the fire out beside her. She said, young man, is the kettle on? And as I was a-sitting by the side of the fire, me wife come in as a-black as a gun. Slap a come her fist into my face, so the poor man's labours are never done. So it's I'll go to me aged mother, she is a-sitting there all alone. Said there's plenty of young women to be had, so why shouldn't I be tied to one? Take the second one and try her, and if you find that she will not do, and take the third one and then the fourth, and then you'll find your follies anew. So it's all young men that means for to marry, be sure and wait for a good wife. Never marry my wife's sister, for she'll grieve you all your life. Never marry your mother's a daughter, for she'll grieve you evermore. Oh, death, come and take my wife, and then my sorrows will be yours.
Sea captain turned down by the banks of Willow. He's courted a pretty girl till she proved a child. Oh, she cried, what shall I do, me love? What will become of me? Me mother and father, they both will disown me. Go fetch me some of your father's gold and some of your mother's money, and you shall sail the ocean along with young Johnny. So she's fetched him some of her father's gold and some of her mother's money, and she has gone aboard a ship along with young Johnny. Well, they had not been sailing scarce 6 weeks nor so many before she was delivered of a beautiful baby. Sea captain, a sea captain, here's £50 for thee to see me safe home again, me and my baby. Oh, no, said the captain, such a things they never can be. 'Tis better to lose two lives than 'tis to lose many. Let me tie the napkin round my head, come tie it soft and easy, and throw me right overboard, me and my baby. So they've tied the napkin round her head, they've tied it soft and easy. They've thrown her right overboard, she and her baby. Don't you see how she swims, me lads? Don't you see how her body quivers? She'll swim till she comes to the banks of green willow. And my love, she'll have a coffin made of a gold that shines yellow. And she shall be buried on banks of green willow. Where have you been, my sweet pretty one? I've been to my sweetheart's mother, make my bed soon, for I'm sick to my heart and fain would lie down. What did she give you, Randall, my son? What did she give you, my sweet, pretty one? She gave me some meals, mother, make my bed soon. But I'm sick to my heart, and fain would lie down. What colour were they, Randall, my son? What colour were they, my sweet, pretty one? All speckled and speckled, mother, make my bed soon, for I'm sick to my heart and fain would lie down. Where did she get them, Randall, my son? Where did she get them, my sweet, pretty one? From hedges, from ditches, mother, make my bed soon, for I'm sick to my heart, and fain would lie down. Where are ye greyhounds, Randall, my son? Where are ye greyhounds, my sweet, pretty one? They swelled and they died, mother, make my bed soon, for I'm sick to my heart, and fain would lie down. I fear 'tis poison, Randall, my son. I fear you were poisoned, my sweet, pretty one. Yes, I'm poisoned, mother, make my bed soon, for I'm sick to my heart, and fain would lie down. it's May she comes and May she goes down beyond garden green. And it's there she spied a gallant squire as a squire had ever been. It's May she comes and May she goes down beyond Holland Tree. And it's there she spied this gallant squire, and a fair young lad was he. Oh, give to me your green mantle, give me your maiden head. If you won't give me your green mantle, give me your maiden head. He's taken her by the milk white hand, and he's gently laid her down. And when he's taken her up again, given her a silver comb, perhaps there may be bairns kind, sir, perhaps there may be none. But if you be a courtier, pray tell to me your name. Oh, I am no courtier, said he, but late come from the sea. Oh, I am no courtier, said he, but when I court thee, they call me Jack when I'm abroad. Sometimes they call me John. But when I'm in my father's bower, Jock Randall is my name. Oh, you lie, you bonny boy, so loud I hear you lie. For I am Lord Randall's only daughter, and he has no one but me. You lie, you bonny maid, so loud I hear you lie. For I am Lord Randall's only son, and he has no one but me. Then she's put her hand into her gown, and out she's ta'en the knife. She's thrust it in her own heart's blood, and she's taken away her life. He's taken up his bonny sister with a salt tear in his eye, and he has buried his bonny sister beneath yon holland tree. And then he's hiding o'er the dale, oh, his father dear to see. Sing, oh, for my bonny hind beneath yon holland tree. Oh, what care you for your bonny hind? For it you need not care, for there's odd score hinds in yonder park, and a 50 hinds to spare. Oh, 40 of them are silver shod, of them you may take 3. But oh, sing now for my bonny hind beneath yon holland tree. What care you for your bonny hind? For it you need not care. Take you the best, leave me the worst, for it's plenty are to spare. Oh, I care not for your hinds, father,
and I care not for your fee. But I'll sing now for my bonny hind beneath yon holland tree. Oh, were you at your sister's bower, your sister fair to see, you would care no more for your bonny hind beneath yon holland tree. Stout and strong, to a lofty vessel I do belong. A well-rigged, well-manned, well-fit for sea, bound for New York in America. Our captain's name was William Gower, and his crew in number were just fourscore. All the seamen bold for to sail the sea, bound for New York in America. Our captain in his cabin lay, when an awful voice to him did say, prepare yourself and your company, tomorrow night in the deep to lie. Our captain woke in an awful fright, it being in the first part all of the night, and to his bosun a loud call to him revealed his secret all. Oh, it's bosun, bosun, let no one know what we poor sailors do undergo. But to keep the secret within your breast, and pray to God now to give you rest. I killed my master, merchant there, and was all for the sake of his lady dear. I killed my wife and my children three, and was all for the sake of jealousy. Oh, it's on my servant I laid the blame, he was hung and quartered, all for the same. And it is his ghost I'm much afraid, this very night has my heart betrayed. Early next morning the storm did rise, which our poor sailors did much surprise. And the sea was tore us both fore and aft, till scarce one man on the deck was left. At this our bosun he did declare, our captain he was some murderer, which is so enraged the whole ship's crew, they overboard. Captain. this was done, oh, calm was there, and our good ship homeward did steer. Oh, the wind abated and calmed the sea, and we sailed a safe to America.
Britannia shall ever be afraid.